Hello students, so students, in the previous class in the chapter that is why do we fall ill, we were discussing about that what are the preventive measures that we should take care, that we should see so that we get rid of any kind of a disease. And in this there were a different points that we had discussed by which we can say that we can prevent ourselves from any kind of a diseases. Like students, you see, the precautions that we should take is providing a good living conditions or a hygienic conditions. Okay, so especially if we are not living in an overcrowded area, then there will be chances, or we can say there will be less chances of the spreading of the diseases. Okay, so providing good living condition is very important by which we can prevent the disease. Second thing is that providing safe drinking water, that if suppose we are not taking the contaminated water, ultimately this water will not going to affect our body and we will be healthy. Okay, but if you are taking a contaminated water and food, then it will cause disease. Now same thing with that of the food article, students, if you are open food articles, you are taking the food which is sold at the roadside, or the open food you are taking, chances are there that may consisting of a microbes which will enter in your body and cause the disease. Then you should encourage people to be hygienic and to maintain the hygiene. Okay, so if you are living in such a condition where the cleanliness is important, where the people are take care of the hygiene, then ultimately it will give a good result. It will make your society clean, and the clean will be there, hygienic will be there, so less chance of microbes to grow. Now not only this, we should encourage people about the immunization, about vaccination, why it is important, and everyone should take the proper vaccine so that we can fight with that of diseases. We had also discussed about the 5 F's, students. 5 F's was what? That if we take care of these 5 F's, then there will be a prevention, means we can prevent the transmission of disease from one person to the other person. Okay, what was that 5 F's, students? So the first one is flus, second one is finger, third one is flies, fourth one is finger is there, flies are there, students, then flood and flood. So these are the 5 F's which we should take care. If we will take care of these 5 F's, then ultimately it will lead to the prevention of the transmission of the diseases. Okay, so you see, student, fluid. So water, it should be stored properly, it should be covered properly. Okay, if it is stored and covered properly, the contaminated water will not going to be contaminated, and ultimately it will the water will be good, that water will be safe for us, and we can drink and prevent the disease. Finger, students, you know that a proper hand wash is very important, because you see, after we are touching the things here and there, and it may consisting of our microbes. So ultimately, if you take anything from that finger, so that microbes may enter in your body. Next one is the flies. You know that flies, it act as a vector, so they used to carry the disease from one person to another, or from the infected person to the healthy person. Okay, so we should take care of it, that flies should not we should control the flies, as well as we should take care that the flies should not reach we should cover, if we should cover, if we will cover our food and all, then ultimately the effect will be very less. Feel the students that after you see that this vegetables and the fruit which comes from the field, we should wash it and then we should take it. Flood, if proper drainage system will be there, if the water should be treated before it goes to the respective places, then ultimately the spreading of the unhygienic or the dirty water will become less, and the prevention of the disease will be occur. Okay, so these are some of the, we can say here, these are the five S which is, if we will take care of this, then ultimately it will lead to the less effect of the diseases to us. Now we will move to the next topic, student, and I told you about it, that is a very important one, and that is known as immunization. Yesterday also I had discussed about the immunization. Now let us write something about it and try to understand it properly. Immunization. So you see, okay, so let us discuss about the immunization, students. So you see, I already had told you about it, that is if suppose an infection attack on your body, okay, or because of an infectious agent we get infected, okay. So this disease will be not longer to be there in our body. It is because our immune system will start preparing itself to fight with that microbe or that of the infectious agent. Right? Now, okay, it prepared itself to fight with that of the infectious agent, but that preparation takes time. It means our immune system, it takes time to fight with that infectious agent and to kill the microbe, okay, or to protect ourselves from that disease. So ultimately we get infected, we got disease, okay. But when this microbe again re-enters in our body, our immune system, it is having a capability to recognize that microbe, and this time our immune system is ready to fight with that microbe, and ultimately it will kill the microbe, it will attack on the, or it will protect us from that infectious agent within a few times, not making us a disease. Okay, so we can say that immunization is what, in which our immune system recognize the microbe and help us to fight with that microbe next time when it enters in our body or when it re-enters in our body. That is known as immunization. Let me write it. That is when we get infected, okay, with some infectious disease. With some infectious disease, with some infectious disease, then we can say that the same disease does not occur for a longer period of a time. For a longer time period. And it is because the infectious agent enters our body is because the infectious agent which enters in our body. Our immune system prepares itself to fight against it. Itself to fight against it. Okay, so when the infectious agent it enters in our body, our immune system it starts preparing itself so that it will fight against that particular disease. Okay, now because since the preparation it takes time. Okay, so our immune system it takes time to prepare itself and thus we become diseased as the first time it happens. So we can say that this preparation of the immune system to fight against that particular infectious agent, it takes time. The preparation of the immune system takes time, so we became diseased. Now let me tell you, this is the first condition it happens, student. When the microbe it enter in your body, your immune system start preparing itself to fight against that particular disease. But this time the immune system is preparing itself to fight against that disease, infectious agent. Which infectious agent? Which the agent or the microbe which enter first time in your body. Okay, so at that time your immune system start preparing itself to fight with that microbe or the infectious agent. But since the preparation means it takes time to prepare itself, and till that we become diseased. So this happened for the first time. Okay, because our immune system is not knowing about that microbe, not knowing about that infectious agent, so it starts preparing itself to fight against that infectious agent. So ultimately it will takes time, until that we become diseased. Okay, so this is the first case. What happened after that? But we can say but our immune system we can say that but then after our immune system remember that infectious agent. Okay, so immune system prepare itself against that disease, but it always remember that infectious agent which caused the disease. Okay, so what happened after that? When this infectious agent or microbe when this infectious agent re-enters into our body, it re-enters into our body. This time our immune system do not take much time because it already had recognized it, students. So it do not take time to recognize it and come in action. Okay, so we can say that when this infectious agent it enter into our body, this time our immune system is ready to fight. Our immune system is ready to fight. Okay. Our immune system is ready to fight. And due to that, the agent get killed immediately. And we do not get diseased. Okay, so you see students, this is the second case. In the first case we discussed that when the microbe it enter in our body, at that time our immune system start preparing itself to fight against that, right? So this, it takes time. Okay, this takes a lot of time, and at this time, student, you can say that till that we get diseased. But when the same agent it enters in our body, then our immune system it is having an ability that it recognizes the microbe and its relative. Okay, so from the next time when this agent enters in our body, then students, it will fight, it will be ready, that immune system is already ready, it recognize the microbe, it recognize the infectious agent, and this time our immune system is ready and it will fight against that agent, kill it immediately, and because of that we do not get disease. So in the first time it was preparing itself, which takes time, and because of that we got the diseases. But in the second time, since it is already familiar with the microbe, with the infectious agent, so it do not take much time and it kill the microbe, it kill the infectious agent which is responsible for causing the disease before the person get diseased. Okay, so this is the self immunization. Okay, so we can say that this is called as self-immunization. This is called the self-immunization, in which we protect ourselves, that is a self-immunization. Okay, so this is called as a self-immunization. Now this term, this concept of a immunization, how does it came, students? So it came because of Edward Jenner. Okay, so let us discuss about him. Who was Edward Jenner? Edward Jenner. Who was Edward Jenner, students? So Edward Jenner, he was a English physician, and he was actually working at that time. He was seeing at his country at that time, the people, most of the people, they were suffering from the smallpox. And what does he notice? That smallpox is what, student? It is highly infectious agent. That is, it get transferred from one person to another person very easily through the contact. Okay. Now you see, students, what did we observe? And at that time, more than 10% of the people of the country will die because of the smallpox. So he observed that the cow, a cow was there, and that cow, which is having cowpox. Okay, so cow was also having pox, but even then also that the milkmen who are very close to the cow, even then also they do not get affected from the pox. Okay, let me tell you again. He was working on the smallpox and he saw that a cow who is having the cowpox, the milkman which is very close to that of the cowpox does not suffer from any kind of a pox or does not suffer from the smallpox. Okay, so he thought that if a milkman is there who is very near to the pox, so he's very close to the pox, close to that of the cow which is having cowpox, and that person is not did not get the smallpox, so there must be some reason. So what does he do? He called a boy and then he taken the blister of that cow and enter it into the body of that boy. Okay, so what did he observe? He find that after 2 days that boy become disease or he got that pox. Okay, then after that, after a few days when he become okay, he become ready, then again he has taken a person who was suffering from the smallpox and take the blister of that the pus of the blister of that person who is suffering from the smallpox and entered into the body of the same boy. Okay, what did you observe? That after 2 days, 3 days, that boy remained the same. Even this time he did not get the fever also. Okay, so what is that he came to know about it? That this cowpox, so this pox, it makes our immune system to recognize that virus of the pox, and because of that, when he entered the first time this pox, this virus pox, virus of the cow pox, then at that time the body was preparing itself to fight against it. Okay, and because of that, since it takes time, that boy become diseased, the boy get the fever, the boy get the pox. But after that, when he recovered, his body get recovered from the pox, after that, when the smallpox was at this time, the immune system is ready to fight with it. Okay, so since the pox was very related to that of the smallpox only, so already the immune system recognized the relative of the microbes. And this time the immune system is very much ready to fight with the smallpox which re-enter in the body of the boy and ultimately cause the disease. So he fight it, that immune system of the boy fight it with that pox, and the boy did not get the disease. So from this concept, from this theory, student, he came to the conclusion that our immune system recognizes the microbes, recognizes the infectious agent. Once it recognizes the infectious agent, later on when you give when the microbes re-enter, the immune system is ready to fight with it and the person did not suffer from the infection. Now we will discuss that what is the definition of a immunization. So Edward Jenner was the first person. Now let me tell you one more thing, student, before we go further. The term vaccination come from the cow is known as a vacca. Okay, and since this term of immunization, the term of vaccination come from the cowpox concept, so he has given the name to it, that is vaccination. Okay, so the term vacca come from the cow, because the cow is known as vacca, so vaccination term came from the vaka itself. Okay. Now let us discuss about the immunization. That what is the definition of immunization? We can say that the practice of strengthening the immune system, we can say. System of the body. Practice of strengthening the immune system of the body is known as immunization. Okay. Okay, so practice of strengthening the immune system of the body is known as a immunization. Now, what happened during the immunization, students? So, during vaccination or immunization, some killed microbes is injected in the body. Killed microbes is injected in the body, which is very much similar to the actual microbe. It is very much similar to the actual microbe. So when actual microbe enter in the body, it is ready to fight with it. Okay, so you see, students, that when at that time during immunization or during vaccination, what we used to do, we used to inject some of the killed microbes. Okay, this microbes, it is very much similar with that of the actual microbes. Okay, so we used to inject. You have heard about the vaccination is done. They used to give the injection. Actually, they give the killed microbes to the body. Okay, so our immune system at that time, because the microbe is very much similar to the actual microbe, so our immune system is able to recognize it. And later on, when the actual microbe enter in our body, our immune system already recognize it, already knowing about it. So it will kill the microbes before it will give disease to the person. Okay, so immunization or a vaccination is a process in which the dead microbes is given to the person and which help it to fight with the actual microbe later on when it enters in the body. You have heard about a lot of our vaccines have been developed, student, against tuberculosis, again diphtheria, again whooping cough or polio. You have heard about it, the pulse polio. The pulse polio abhiyan is going in India from 1995. Okay, so there are a lot of our vaccine. You have heard hepatitis also. Okay, tuberculosis. So all these are vaccines have been developed to cure a person from getting infected from a disease. Okay, so this is all about the vaccination. Tuberculosis is there, diphtheria is there, whooping cough is there, measles are there, polio is there. All these are the different kind of a disease whose vaccine has been discovered. Vaccine used to be given to the small kids, to the people, and which help in making our immune system strong. So whenever we say that immunization help in making our immune system strong, so this is the way by which we can make our immune system to be strong. Okay.